I know you guys aren't expecting this video, but it's my reality, and you know I live my life like an open book, so I gotta give y'all the real 100% of the time. What's going on? It's Anton from AntonDaniels.com. As you can see, I'm at the restaurant. It's right after Halloween, and we have officially decided to close the restaurant. So I don't anticipate this video being that long. And you also have to excuse my voice because I've been at the Pistons game, yelling, screaming, hollering. So it's just now starting to get back. And then I've been partying with a lot of friends that's been in and out of town. But long story short, it wasn't a profitability issue. It wasn't an issue as it relates to the business itself. I just realized that it took more than I anticipated as it relates to day-to-day, every single day activities for me to run this restaurant, and then the return wasn't as big as some other businesses that I have. So I decided to focus all of my energy on the businesses with the biggest growth. So the thing about the restaurant business, and I would say 98 to 99% of all businesses in general, is that it requires you to be there and to massage it. There's any business that people are telling you guys that you can just run and it's just automatic and you just get checks or whatever, it's only a couple of different businesses that I can think of and that I know of people that participates in, which I'm involved in a couple of those too. But even those aren't like you can just sit back and chill. It's a lot of legwork. It's a lot of work. It's a lot of different things that goes along with that. But very few businesses in the world that I can think of outside of scamming somebody requires you to be, or, you know, allows you to be able to just sit and chill and not collect. I mean, you know, not actually be there to massage it. Restaurant business is certainly not one of them. One of the mistakes that I made earlier on in this process, not as it relates to the business itself, but just underestimating the amount of time that I had to spend here, making sure that things ran right, making sure employees did what they're supposed to do, making sure that I'm not getting, you know, they're not stealing from me. Somebody calls off, you gotta be there, all of that, you know what I'm saying? And then you start to evaluate how much your time is worth. One of the mistakes that I made earlier on was that, as you guys know, I just recently quit my job, but one of the mistakes I made earlier on was that I was still, you know, putting in 60, 70 hours a week in corporate America. Then I had to run my other businesses. And then I was supposed to run the restaurant full time too. So, you know, for the better part of a year, I probably only averaged 2 to 3 hours of sleep a day. And that's just not healthy. I started to pick up a lot of weight. I started to be a lot more stressed out because I didn't believe in excuses. I still don't believe in excuses. I don't believe in failure. But then at the same time, it's like, you know, what is failure? And how important is your health? You know, one of the things that happened recently, I can hear the fire trucks and stuff. I'm trying to let these things go by. Anyways, one of the things that recently happened, not to me, but to a fellow entrepreneur in the area, was that he wound up, I think he had a heart attack and he died. But he was a restaurant owner, and, you know, it just, I guess, the day-to-day grind over so many years just became too stressful, and it took him out. And I don't, you know, want to be that successful to where I can't be there for my daughter and things, you know, I can't travel without worrying, which is, you go out of town, you go places. You know, as you guys know, I just really started traveling a lot more lately since I had quit my job. But one of the things, as you guys know, is that I used to travel a whole lot more than I have been recently. And I can attribute a lot of that to the restaurant. So in addition to that, there's some other things. Rita, you know, who I wind up relying on more and more so that I can get a little bit of sleep. You know, she had career aspirations and things that she wanted to do, that she wanted to cross off her bucket list. And it wasn't fair to her long term for me to require her to participate in something that I started and I was running, you know, And don't get me wrong, she loved it just as much as I did. But at the same time, you know, you got to evaluate at what point in your life do you want to do certain things? And then, you know, how long do you put other things that you want to do in addition to that on hold until you can, you know, get around to it so that you can run this thing? And it just never ends. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're going to have a lot of turnover. We paid a lot of money per hour as, you know, in correlation to what the minimum wage is. We pay significantly more than that. And you, people just don't want to work. They don't have the work ethic. They don't put the time in. People going to call off. They're going to get drunk. They're going to all of that stuff. Like, it's crazy. And how long do you want to deal with that? You know what I'm saying? No matter how well the processes are that you put in place, you can't prevent human error. You know what I'm saying? If I'm not here, are they doing what they're supposed to do? If Rita not here, are they doing what they're supposed to do? And again, like I said, Rita has her own dreams and perspectives, things that she want to cross off her bucket list in addition to the restaurant also. So, you know, like I said, it was a really, really fun ride. I enjoyed it. I learned a lot. You know, I got the type of education that you can't get. And I was profitable. You know, a lot of people can't say that they was profitable and that, you know, the reason why they're no longer participating and being in the restaurant business is because, you know, it just doesn't make sense for their lifestyle. So I appreciate everybody that came to see me, visit me, that participated in the success of this restaurant. But it's time to move on. And every story is not a bad story of transition. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes it just makes the most sense. As a matter of fact, I think that the best entrepreneurs have an exit plan or can realize when it doesn't line up with what it is that they're trying to do, you know, or it's no longer as profitable as other businesses that they may have in their portfolio. So, yeah, it was fun. And I'm going to still give you guys game as it relates to business and understanding business, the restaurant business. I got new things that's coming. I got other businesses that I started that I've been cultivating over the last probably 6 to 7 months, and that's going really, really well. And I'm thankful. I'm thankful that I had the opportunity to do this, that I, you know, put my own money up, because, you know, it don't count if you invest in with other people's money. You got to put your own money up if you really believe in what it is that you're doing. So I appreciate y'all. This is not meant to be a long video. It's just meant to, you know, give y'all some insight into what's going on in my life. And of course, there's more to come. You know I drop videos every single week. I love you guys. I appreciate you. I'll holler at y'all later. Make sure you holler at me at AntonDaniels.com. I've been posting, you know, written articles, you know, because I've been blogging a lot more outside of the videos. Look at this. This, the Halloween decorations getting stuck in my shoes. That's not good. Got some business meetings to go to. Did y'all see our decorations? I'll show y'all. It's dope, right? I am gonna miss this place. I'm gonna miss it as a place where, you know, we used to come and hang out at night, cook up some good food, place where we can go and eat, you know, where we owned and things like that. But like I said, you know, it must all come to a close. Gotta show y'all the kitchen still. Gotta do a little bit more cleaning up, all of that. But yeah, it's been fun, it's been dope, and I truly enjoyed the experience. So, till the next video, I love y'all. Again, holler at me at AntonDaniels.com and all of my social media platforms. Peace.